Welcome back to The Lowdown. We are in New York because we'll be hanging out with New York street photographer Dave Krugman. We're going to talk about NFT photography, the NFT community. I'm super pumped, so stick around. It's going to be a fun episode here on The Lowdown. Nice to meet you, man. Dave, I'm super pumped that you're here. I'm a big fan of your work, actually. I've been scrolling through your Instagram feed, and your photography is just stunning. It's bold, it's bright, everything is just, I love your photography, man. So thanks for being here.
Thanks so much, it's an honor to be here.
So you've been a photographer for quite some time, right? So how did you start off in photography?
So funnily enough, photography kind of runs in my family. My grandfather and father were both avid hobbyists. They actually had a dark room growing up in the house. And when I was born, I was always surrounded by cameras, like my whole early childhood. And I was a little bit camera shy, but I ended up really becoming fascinated with the technology and like the ability to freeze time. It always fascinated me.
Well, we're here to talk about NFT photography and the NFT community. And so for someone that is not too familiar with the NFT world, what is an NFT?
So an NFT is the first time we can have digital original objects. And that's really important because to have any sort of marketplace, you kind of need the ability to designate something as a one-of-one item. And once you have that, the possibilities are really endless.
So for photographers wanting to get into NFT photography, is there something that they should prep themselves with, or is it just photography on a different level? Like, where can a photographer start out?
Yeah, that's a great question. I think that nothing about people's craft and process has to change. Like, there's nothing you need to do with your photography to make it NFT-able. It's just a technology layer that allows you to signify a digital original. There's two things you really need to focus on. One is you need to be a very good community builder. Like, you really need to have people that are kind of on your team. And the other thing is consistency and cohesion. So like, if you have a project, like, you need to think about how that whole project fits together. So like, I did a collection called Drive, and it's all these cars, and they all kind of match, right? But you know, when you have collectibles and stuff like that, like, think about Pokemon cards, or think about like old baseball cards, they all kind of fit into a set, and people really identify with that set. And if somebody collects something, there's enough individuality in the piece they collect, but it also fits into this larger umbrella of work that makes them feel like they're a part of a community.
Let's get more into your creative process as a photographer. It's a beautiful day outside, and so I say, let's go outside, hang out, and shoot some photos.
Let's hit it.
So Dave, as a New York street photographer, what's your creative process like?
You know, I love to wander around and observe all the beautiful overlaps of life. And I think that photography is really the art of observation. And you can even do it without a camera. You know, I walk around and I just like look at the world and the way light hits, and I look at all the laws of physics, and I get to kind of experience this wandering process of creation.
And I have become a recent fan of yours, like I've said before, and I love how you explain your camera settings and your reasons why you compose a shot. So can you talk a little bit more about that?
Yeah, absolutely. So when you're capturing these overlaps and things that happen at the confluences of different circumstances, you have a lot of creative control in your camera settings. And one of the reasons I love shooting with Sony is it gives me a really good opportunity to push the boundaries of what I'm able to capture. For example, I love to shoot at really fast shutter speeds and low light when, like, in rainy situations, because the dynamics of like the physics of rain and light and you know, timing are really interesting. And at very high shutter speeds, you can really just freeze those moments entirely and actually see things that you can't even see with your own eyes. And that's really fascinating to me.
And when it comes to NFT photography, is the creative process a little bit different?
Honestly, I don't think it is for me. I think that my craft is my craft, and NFTs are just a technology layer that allows me to signify a digital original. And before NFTs, we really never had a way to do that. Everything was a copy of a copy of a copy of a copy. And what NFTs give us and blockchain technology gives us is this root layer. And it's almost like the DNA of my creativity. Like, I get to really signify like where my ideas exist in that root layer, and it turns all of my social media and everything else into this layer above it, where all of everything I'm doing there just helps, like, you know, bring attention to the original items that I'm actually producing.
As a creative, there is a lot of importance when it comes to community, right? And there's a lot of community regarding NFT photography. So can you speak a little bit into that in your community?
Absolutely. So the thing about community is, I think all value is kind of rooted in community. You know, if you're on a desert island with $1 billion, it doesn't really matter, right? What you really need is other people. And NFTs are a way to kind of include your community in the equity of your creative ideas. There's a tremendous amount of value in creativity. And you know, everything we look at, you know, is somebody designed it. Somebody had a piece of that. And I really love the idea that, you know, I can issue these, you know, tokens, NFTs is non-fungible tokens, and people who are very invested in the communities I'm building can participate in owning that, and not only helping me create my creative ideas, but also, like, you know, they're, because they're involved and they have participation in everything we're doing, their contributions are just as valuable as mine, and that's really special.
Well, that wraps up this episode of The Lowdown. Thank you, Dave, for hanging out and teaching us about NFT photography and your creative process. If you want to follow Dave, and you have to follow Dave, make sure to follow him on his Instagram channel and Twitter. Also, subscribe to our channel. We appreciate that. And we'll see you in the next episode of The Lowdown.